Welcome to Module 4 discussion of Chapter Number 8, The Rocks and Minerals. This is page number 82. Through this interactive video session, today we are going to learn about the very important topic of this chapter, and that is the fossil fuel. We have to know first the meaning of fossil fuel and what are the different examples of fossil fuels. In form of fossil fuels, in this video we are going to learn mainly about two different types of fossil fuels as the source of energy, such as number one, coal as a fossil fuel. What is coal and what is the formation, what is the way of formation of coal? And the second one is the petroleum as a fossil fuel, and what is the way of formation of petroleum and the uses of petroleum as well. Before defining the term fossil fuels, I would like to start with the meaning of fossil, the word, and the fuel, the another word, individually. First, I would like to explain the inner meaning of the word fossil. Fossil, this is the word. It means obtained something by digging. I repeat, fossil, it is the word that means obtained something by digging process. For example, if something is obtained by the process of digging, then this will be known as fossil. In detail, we can put an example in front of you. Let's assume that we want to have the oil, and the oil or coal, let's say, we can easily obtain by the complex process of digging as well as the extraction, and this will be known as the fossil. The obtaining of something by digging, this is the meaning of fossil. But fossil is quite different from the process of digging, from the process of extraction. Digging, it is concerned with the fossil term, but extraction, the process, is not concerned with the term fossil. Although the process extraction means obtaining something, but as we know, the digging process is totally different from the process of extraction. That's why extraction process is not involved in the term or with the term fossil. Only digging, the process, is involved with the term fossil. In similar word, we can say fossil means mainly obtaining the coal by the process of digging. I hope the term fossil is clear. Now let us understand what is the meaning of fuels. This second term, we can say fuels are those organic combustible materials which are mainly derived from the dead or decayed remains of plant as well as animal's body. For example, coal, it is the fuel. Gas, this is also the fuel. Different oils such as petroleum, diesel, kerosene, etc. These are also the example of fuels. And don't forget that these kind of fuels are the good source of energy. In another statement, we can also define the term fuels in this way, that fuels are also called the hydrocarbon containing materials. I repeat, fuels are also the hydrocarbon containing materials of biological origin that occur within the earth crust or beneath the soil. And this kind of fuels can be used as a non-renewable source of energy. I repeat, all fossil fuels, irrespective of either liquid or solid or gas, these are mainly the source of non-renewable energy. They are caused to environmental pollution. That means they lead to environmental pollution. But gas is a kind of or a type of fossil fuel that cannot lead to the environmental pollution as compared to coal and the oils such as petroleum, diesel or kerosene to some extent. But the oils, petroleum, diesel and kerosene and the coals, these are mainly those fossil fuels which are responsible for excessive environmental pollution. I hope the two terms fossil and the fuels are very much clear to you all. Now we are heading for the definition of fossil fuel, or what is the real meaning of the fossil fuels. See, fossil fuels are natural fuels which were formed under the ground or beneath the soil in the geological time or in geological past time over millions of years from the decayed remain or dead remains of organisms, both the plant and the other living organisms, excluding the animal's body, mainly the plant's body. These are the fossil fuels. I would like to mention some important information which are based on the fossil fuels, such as, number one, when the fossil fuels are burnt, the carbon dioxide is produced in huge amount in the environment that causes the greenhouse effect of the environment. The another important information about the fossil fuels is that the fossil fuels reserves are nowadays rapidly being depleted due to the overuses. That means in our near future, it is famously said by the scientists that around 2050, in the year 2050, the reservoir of fossil fuels is going to be exhausted due to the overuse or excess use of such this kind of fossil fuels. The third one about the fossil fuel information is gas is the only fossil fuel among the other fossil fuels having less environmental effects or problems. But the gas, other than gas, the oil such as petroleum, diesel, kerosene or the coal plays a pivotal role in environmental pollution as compared to gas. Now we are going to discuss about the coal. Coal as a fossil fuel. We have learnt in our previous lesson that coal, it is a sedimentary rock. It is a sedimentary rock. And coal is the example of fossil fuel. But basically coal is a type of sedimentary rock. And such kind of fossil fuel as coal is formed from the dead remains of the plant. I repeat, from the plant only. Over millions of years, due to the intense heat and pressure under the soil. Now we have to know how the coal was formed as a fossil fuel beneath the soil, or we can say what is the process of formation of coal as a fossil fuel. In this regard, we have to know the meaning of few terms first, such as the meaning of heat or temperature, the pressure, the swamps, and the forest. I hope the meaning of these terms are clear to all you. And just I would like to mention the process of formation of coal. It is the very simple process of coal formation. Over millions of years, when the thick forests on the earth that grew in the swamps when died were buried in the beneath the soil, and due to the decomposition of many layers of sand, mud, and due to the intense amount of heat and pressure, such decomposed dead bodies of the plant along with the decomposition or deposition of the sands, they transformed into the coal. This is the formation of coal. Now we have to know what is the meaning of swamp. Swamp means in your book it has been written here, it is a marshy land or the bog, or we can say also the moorland. But in general terms, swamps means a low level land that is seasonally flooded. And the forest which were grown to this moorland or the marshy land, and due to the excess flood, when this forest were died and buried beneath the soil, and due to the decomposition of many layers of sand, and due to the excess amount of heat and pressure which are applied on this the decomposed or the decayed plant were transformed into the coal, and this is the way of formation or the process of the formation of the coal as fossil fuel. There is another important information about coal, and that is coal sorry that is when we burn coal as fuel, we generally use the trapped energy of the sun that is present in the coal. I repeat, when we burn coal as fuel, we mainly use the trapped energy of the sun in the coal. The reason is, as we know, sun's energy makes the plant grow, and hence the coal stores the energy of the sun throughout the millions of years ago. And that's why when we burn the coal, we mainly use the trapped energy of the sun in the coal. This is important about the coal as a form of energy. And always remind that coal is a source of energy, but it is a non-renewable source of energy. That means one day the coal reservoir will be exhausted due to the overuse, and we cannot recycle the formation of coal. That's why the coal as a fossil fuel is termed as non-renewable source of energy. Now we are going to learn about the another fossil fuel, and that is the petroleum. There is an important term, and that is the organic. We have to know the meaning of organic first. Organic means something that is related to living organism, or we can say organic is related to the living organism, maybe the plant or maybe the animal. First, we have to know about the petroleum. Like the coal, petroleum is also the fossil fuel. But to specifically mention about the petroleum, we can say petroleum is the crude oil. What is petroleum? Petroleum is the crude oil, and it is found in the vast underground reservoir area where the ancient seas were located, such as we can find the petroleum or the crude oil beneath the land or the ocean floor. And now the question is, how the petroleum was formed beneath the soil or beneath the land or beneath the ocean floor? And the answer is, the similar process as I mentioned earlier about the coal is responsible for the formation of the petroleum. But there is only one difference between the formation of petroleum and the coal. Coal is mainly formed from the plant, but the petroleum is formed from the organisms such as both from the plant and as well as the animal living, even dead body or dead or decayed remains. This is the main difference between the formation of coal and the petroleum. In coal, plant decayed remains used, but in case of the formation of petroleum, only the decayed or the dead plant as well as the animal remains used. Now the answer is about the formation of petroleum. When the marine plants and the animals, marine means the sea related living organisms such as the sea plants or the sea animals, when these marine plants and animals living were dead and their bodies sank to the bottom of the sea floor, and due to the decomposition of more layers of sediments on the top of that bodies and due to the intense amount of heat and pressure over the millions of years, these plants and the animals, along with the decomposition of different sediments, they were transformed or converted into the petroleum. This is the transformation of the dead bodies of marine plants and animals, don't forget, due to and along with the decomposition of different sediments and due to the excess amount of or intense amount of pressure and heat. This is the petroleum. That means, in short, we can say petroleum, it is the transformation of the decayed or the dead bodies of the marine plants and the animals into the petroleums over millions of years due to the excess amount of pressure and the heat applied over millions of years. This is the petroleum. As I mentioned earlier, petroleum is mainly the crude oil. There is another important fact about the petroleum, and that is this crude oil is extracted with the help of giant machine. Now you may consult this picture. This is the giant machine, and the process that is involved in the extraction of petroleum is called the extraction. This is the process that is involved mainly in the taking out of the petroleum under the ground. If I ask the question how petroleum is taken out from the underground, the answer is the process of extraction. This process is used by the giant machine in order to take out the petroleum from the underground. I hope the process of taking out of the petroleum is clear, and the process is the extraction. And this process is done with the help of the giant machine. This is how we can easily extract the petroleum. Like the coal, the petroleum is also contained the stored energy of the sun. Like coal. Now, what are the different uses of petroleum? They can be petroleum can be used in form of, you may see here, either different petrol, diesel or kerosene, and it can also be used as medicine, cosmetic, fertilizer and the plastic. That means nowadays, in modern days, petroleum can also be used for making different important chemicals along with the different forms of oils, petroleum, diesel and kerosene, such as the medicine. That means petroleum can also be used for making important chemicals such as medicine, cosmetic, fertilizer, plastic and many others. We can also mention about the color of petroleum. We can find the petroleum in different color, such as black color, in dark color, brown color or yellowish color or reddish or even greenish color. Now the question is, why such kind of variations in coloration of crude oil is found? The answer is, the variation that present in the coloration of crude oil, it indicates the distinct chemical composition, the presence of distinct chemical composition. And due to this presence of distinct chemical compositions, different color of petroleum, different colors of petroleums are found, such as black, in black color, in dark brown color or yellowish color, etc. Petroleum can also be used to make gasoline, to make life jacket and for anesthetics. Anesthetics means mainly the pain reliever. And as I mentioned earlier, all kind of fossil fuels are mainly non-renewable energy source. Likely we can say petroleum is also the non-renewable source of energy. And it should also be noted that the oil supplies in our near future, to say exactly, in the year 2050, the oil supplies will run out due to excess amount of use or overuse. This is all about the discussion of the fossil fuel. I hope the concept is clear to you all. In our next video or the upcoming video, we will discuss about the module 5, the last module of this chapter, about how to conserve the natural resources and what are the necessities or need for conservation of the natural resources. This is the upcoming video. Thanks for watching.